You are listening to the Starter Girls podcast with Jennifer Loading. Whether you are starting a project, starting a business, starting a brand, or starting a movement, we are here to talk about it. And I'm super excited today because I have Nakia Fuller on the show today. Welcome, Nakia. How are you?
Hi. Thank you for having me, Jennifer.
Yeah, and thank you for being on here. So what I'm going to do real quick, I'm going to tell our listeners a little bit about you, and then we're going to get right to this because I've got some questions I want to ask you. So, all right, Nakia Fuller is a Texas native blogger, influencer, public speaker, makeup artist to the stars, beauty educator, beauty editor, and founder of Nakia's Academy of Makeup, Nakia's Cosmetics of Hollywood, Man by Nakia, and All Things Beauty, a world-renowned blog sharing the very best in beauty, fashion, entertainment, and lifestyle. Nakia has the wonderful pleasure of introducing her blog readers to many of the best while also influencing for global brands, including AT&T, Samsung, luxury fragrance brands, plus-size clothing brands, Lane Bryant, and Eloquel, just to name a few. Nakia makes a great impact in many areas of beauty, fashion, entertainment. She's written educational beauty articles as a beauty editor for magazines in London. As a professional makeup artist and male groomer, she works with many of Hollywood's most famous faces, including Harrison Ford, Chaka Khan, Pierce Brosnan, Russell Simmons, Victoria Justice, and Mike Epps, just to name a few. Her client list and her credentials are quite exceptional. Nakia has been featured on numerous television shows such as WeTV's My Fair Wedding with David Tatera, Running Russell Simmons on the Oxygen Network, Married to Medicine on Bravo, and more. She's worked her natural gift in the world of beauty, fashion, and entertainment for almost two decades. She continues to be a dynamic force, flawlessly enhancing women and grooming men, hosting and commenting on numerous panels and red carpets, all while blogging for brands around the world. She's often invited as a special guest speaker for women's conferences, young women's mentoring programs, women's organizations, and special events. As well, Nakia and her beauty team are often spotted behind the scenes in Hollywood, working their makeup brushes, enhancing both men and women for exclusive world-renowned events such as the SAG Awards, Golden Globes, Grammys, the BET Awards, New York Fashion Week, and LA Fashion Week. As a proud ambassador of the Susan G. Komen Foundation and an advocate of breast cancer awareness, Nakia Fuller is one who is quite passionate about quality, healthy product ingredients that are beautiful both on and off camera, and for every skin tone. Her focus are ingredients that are non-toxic, paraben-free, long-lasting, organic, and animal cruelty-free products that are made of the finest quality ingredients, and most importantly, are healthy for the skin. I am super excited to have you on here, Nakia. So welcome to the show. My goodness,
thank you.
You have such an incredible bio. I love it. I love it.
Thank you.
So I wanted to, I guess, find out, how did this journey come about for you? Because I know you and I talked off of this, and like I said, you just have this incredible story. Tell us how this all came about for you.
You know, it's interesting because I tell people all the time, a lot of times we don't realize our gift. We don't realize our path. You know, and being in Texas, from Texas, I remember years ago before I discovered my passion, I just remember having a desire to wanting everybody to look good. I was always making people over, you know, even if it was from afar. I would see someone, you know, at work or wherever, and I would always say, if she would just put on a little more blush, oh my gosh, she would look amazing in a red lip or a pink lip. So it was just like, I had no idea that this was my destiny. It was my journey. And then, you know, once I discovered that being a professional makeup artist is an actual career, it's, you know, an actual lifelong career, that's when my eyes opened and I said, oh my God, that little tingle in my stomach is real, you know? So, you know, years ago, I got my first agent and she's, you know, put me to work. And I literally learned hands-on, you know, doing makeup for a Coca-Cola campaign and, you know, her walking me through how to tweak it and how to make sure that, you know, that I don't add too much or that I put enough. And I said, oh, wow, this is amazing. And then when I discovered that gift, I said, okay, how do I take this further? How do I execute this? How do I leave corporate America and supplement my income? Because that passion, it would not leave me alone. You know, it's that thing that we wake up thinking about. We go to bed thinking about it. And so some people ignore it, but it was there comes a time, and I share with everyone, that you just can't ignore it. You know, it won't leave you alone. And so I just jumped on it and said, all right, here we go. And I don't know if you had a chance to watch my interview about the screwdriver.
I didn't see that one yet. No, I didn't see that.
Oh my gosh.
You gotta watch it.
Oh, you have to watch it. I drove to Hollywood I think it was 2005, 2006 with a screwdriver because my car was stolen the night before. I was scheduled to leave Texas and move to LA, and I had less than 48 hours to be on a movie set in Hollywood as department head for makeup. And it was so crazy because I said, okay, I'm going to do this. I got my first big gig in Hollywood, and I sold everything out of my apartment in Las Colinas in Dallas. And I said, I'm out of here. Here we go. And I woke up to drive and my car wasn't there. And I said, okay, somebody stole my car. So the first thing I did, I panicked.
Yeah.
And I said, oh, let me call the finance company. I know I paid my car note, you know?
Right.
So I called and they said, we don't have your car. Why won't we have your car? I said, what am I going to do? Make a long story short, the police found my car on the side of 635, on the side of the freeway, because the thief ran out of gas.
Wow.
I said, oh my God, what am I going to do? My uncle gave me a screwdriver, put it in the ignition, and I drove from Texas to Hollywood with a screwdriver in the ignition. And he said, no matter what you do, you cannot let this screwdriver fall out of the ignition or the car will fall dead. So there I was rolling 26 hours with a screwdriver. And so when I hear people make excuses about, well, they don't want to leave their comfort zone, they're scared about following their passion, I said, you know, I share my story. And I share with them, listen, I'm from a place where I grew up very comfortably. My family, my parents took great care of me. I'm used to living comfortably. And here I was leaving my comfort zone, and not only leaving my comfort zone, which I really wasn't that comfortable because I'm leaving corporate America,
right.
you know? And so here I am leaving my comfort zone to go to a place, a different state where I knew absolutely no one. And I'm having to get there with the screwdriver. So that's how it all started. And I said, you know what? This cannot be in vain. This could never be in vain. I get to LA. I was scheduled to be on that movie set by 6 a.m. I literally got there like 5:59.
Wow.
Jumped out of the car with my makeup kit, hand throbbing. And I walked into that makeup trailer like I lived there, been there before. And that movie director had no idea that I had driven from another state. And I think about that, and I have thought about that over the years. And I just want to say to you, Jennifer, that's how it all started. The screwdriver.
I love it. Oh my goodness. That is so, I'm envisioning you driving with this screwdriver in your car. But the thing, the lesson here is so powerful, just the not giving up. And you had this vision and this dream of what you wanted to do, and you just went with it. Like, you're like, I'm going to make this happen. I love this, because you're right. So many times people get these ideas, and I always talk about like gut intuition. Like, you get these ideas, and if they like kind of keep back, you know, nagging at you, like they just sort of kind of keep coming at you, and you do nothing, then it's just a disgrace. I mean, you just let it go, you know? So this story is so powerful. Thank you for sharing that. That is incredible. And I don't know how I missed that. I need to go back and look on your stuff. I follow you. It's so fun. I love looking at your pictures. That's where I have so much fun, is just looking at your pictures and stuff, all the creativity. And, you know, this is kind of a funny question. So when you were a child, were you like really creative, just always really like, you know, just, I mean, did you know this was going to be something you were going to, because you were in corporate. So did you like as a child be like, hey, one day I'm going to just be this great or do these big things, you know?
Actually, you know, my mother reminded me that, and she reminds me of this all the time, that when I would play dress up, where other kids were dressing up as a princess or a cartoon character, my costume was always a business lady, you know?
Interesting.
And I always... She said I wanted a briefcase and I wanted heels and I wanted pearls and makeup and I wanted to dress up as a business lady. And she said, where is she getting this from? But my mother herself is creative. She's a nurse by trade, but she you know, growing up, I remember being ashamed to walk into the classroom. I went to private school most of my childhood.
Okay.
And walking into the classroom because of the way she would dress me. It was, I was went to school as a child in suits and ruffles and sequin belts. And, you know, so she's fat, total fashionista. And me being her only daughter, she literally would make my design my clothes. I remember her putting ruffles and sequins on my socks and Easter having gloves and big hair bows and oh my, just over the top. And I would be so ashamed because I was always overdone.
Yeah.
And, you know, and so it was in me, you know, it was in her.
Right.
And she dreamed of being a designer in New York City. I never knew that. She had these great dreams, but she had a husband and kids. And so she designed me. And so it was such an honor. I remember her first trip to Hollywood. It was LA Fashion Week and she hit the red carpet and everyone's like, look at your mom. Look at your mom. She had her stance together. Like, yes, I belong here. And then I knew, I said, oh, okay, you groomed me for this because this is
right.
You know, so it's kind of a funny story.
I think that is so awesome. But I'm sure she is one proud mom. You know what I mean? Like this is huge, you know, to watch your child grow up and be successful and follow their dreams, because this is such a thing. I mean, especially, you know, in doing something what you're doing, it's really hard to do that. You know, so many people don't ever like cross over that. And that's the thing I love about what I do with this podcast, because I get to talk to all these people that have done these incredible things. That's what gets me excited, is seeing people come from, you know, maybe you were in an ordinary home or whatever, it wasn't bad, but you decided, I'm going to step out and I'm going to make a difference and I'm going to do something that I really want to do. And you've not only created one business, I mean, you've got several things going on here. So that's why I said, I was reading your bio and I'm going through it. I'm like, what do I leave out of here? There's so many incredible things in here that you've done. I love it. I love it. So let's talk about this other business, because you told me about this networking thing. Talk about this. Tell us a little bit about what this is that you're creating so our listeners can hear this, because I think this is another, you know, really neat deal that you've got going here. And I know you're going to be launching that here pretty soon.
Yes, I'm very excited about my new baby, Brunch and Beauties. You know, I came up with this idea simply because I love networking. I love seeing other women network and connect to help each other. One thing I will share, you know, a lot of times people think, oh, I can do it alone. I did a lot of things alone, but I also, as my company grew, from me just being a professional makeup artist and traveling with my celebrity clients, it grew beyond that. It grew into having a makeup academy, then having a makeup line, and then having a blog. All of that requires a team.
Right.
And so I have a powerful team behind me that handles the posting, the setup of the office, ordering the product, shipping the product, teaching the classes. And so with having a dynamic team, I met each and every one of my staff. Each person that is delegated to do a particular task is gifted in their own area. I met them through networking. Right. Being at a Hollywood party, being at a show, a theater, watching a show at a theater, wherever. Networking. And I tell people, you can't be afraid to shake hands with one another and say, hello, my name is, and share what you do. So I launching Brunch and Beauties. I just finished recording the last segment of my digital course, and I'll tell you about that in just a moment. But I'm launching that so that women can connect powerfully and be a resource to one another. Because I love to dine, I love fine dining and great food and awesome restaurants, I said, hey, let's brunch. So in Hollywood, as well as in Dallas, I love getting women together saying, hey, let's meet for brunch on Saturday. And then I'll call up a few other ladies and say, hey, can you come to brunch on Saturday? And then it's fabulous because you have all these women and everybody's having a good time and they're networking and they're starting businesses together. They're helping each other with their businesses. And I said, you know what? Let's make this official. I want to make this official. So Brunch and Beauties is a membership. It is a network, a community of women that are coming together to help one another, to inspire one another, to empower one another, because it's so important that women come together and help each right. other, you know, not fight each other, not be catty, not be envious, but to say, you know what? I can help you. I know what you need. What I do is make you look good.
I love it.
Sure that your skin's flawless and healthy with organic, non-toxic products. I make sure that if you need a hairstylist, if you need a good manicure, if you need a massage, you know, that's my area. If you need a fashion stylist or a great photographer, that's what I can do. And that's all a part of business,
right?
Your image, right?
Right.
So there's others that say, oh, I need an attorney. Oh, I need a good foot doctor. You know, I need an eye doctor. You know, having a community of women that can be a great resource to each other is very important. So that's what my new baby is all about, Brunch and Beauties. And we will brunch and be inside and out. We will be empowered and we will help one another to grow. So that's my new baby. I'm excited about her.
I can tell. And I love that because I'm with you 100% on the whole empowering women and helping each other, because so many times women are, they can be catty. And this is such a positive. I mean, I talk about, you know, having been in the field that I was in, I always had really great mentors. And so I never really knew what it was like not to have those. And we created that culture where women were empowering each other and supporting each other. So I love that you're basically recreating something like this, because you are right. Networking is everything. It's not everything. What you know. It is who you know. I am 100% with you on that. And you need connections.
Yes.
That's the first thing I do when I'm looking for stuff. I call people I know. I'm like, who do you know that does this? Tell me the people.
Yes.
So
totally.
I love this, and I'm super excited and looking forward to this coming out. I'm excited to see what you got going with that. So tell us, what's the next big thing you've got coming up? Like, what's going to be coming up next for you, like project-wise,
oh,
or besides this thing you're doing here?
Well, here's the thing. I've been asked to get into film and television. When I say film and television, not just normally I'm behind the scenes. So I've been fighting coming out front and coming in front of the camera for many, many years. I was recently pulled into a AT&T campaign. I was there doing makeup, and the producer and director walked over to the makeup station and said, "Why isn't she in the commercial? We love her look.
Yeah.
Like, she's dynamic. She has a huge, she has a great following. Like, why aren't we using her in the commercial?" And I'm going, no. I'm just the makeup artist, you know? And they're like, no, you're coming. We want you. Get her paperwork. And before I knew it, I was doing a contract. So that has led to, we filmed that. That campaign, I end up being a part of the campaign. It's funny to me and I laugh because it's like, I have literally run away from being in front of the camera for some time. Recently received a call from a particular talent agency saying, "Hey, we want to represent you. We want to get you on TV. You have done so much, but let's get you on television. You need a show." And I'm like, I have turned down shows in the past because I just didn't want, you know, I'm not a huge fan of reality TV. I didn't want a reality show. And now I'm being approached to do a few TV shows.
So we'll
see how that goes.
Yeah, I think it would be fun. We'd all be checking it out.
Thank you.
I think it would be fun. I think you could be great at that. You have a great personality and you are fun and you do have great energy. And I think that's really, I mean, it's the following and the energy and all of that that's going to create that. And so I honestly think it would be kind of fun to see some kind of, like, I don't know if you did like a makeup show or something, you know, like a behind the scenes or something. I think that would be kind of fun to watch, you know? So
yeah.
You have to keep us posted on that, definitely.
I will.
So tell us a little bit about your cosmetic line so we know what you got going there, and so our listeners can hear a little bit about, because I've talked about it a little bit in the bio, but you want to share some stuff with us about that?
Sure. Nakia Cosmetics of Hollywood, my other baby. I've worked for many different cosmetic brands over the years. I used to sell Mary Kay. I put myself through my college courses selling Mary Kay. Worked for MAC Cosmetics. I've done training for multiple brands and that have taken me around the world. And finally, I launched my new brand, my new baby, a few years ago. She's organic. She's non-toxic. We do not test on animals, so we are animal cruelty-free. My brand is for everyone. It's for every culture, every race, every age. We have a pretty large range of color shades. I can literally look at a photo and match someone in my brand. And we spend a lot of time matching women overseas, Europe, all over the world, actually, in the United States as well. And I'm so passionate about ingredients. I've always been an ingredients junkie. Even during my MAC Cosmetics days, I would pack the ingredients manual because I always wanted to know what's in this.
Right.
What is this smell? And a lot of times, you know, women, we don't think when we put our makeup on, Jennifer, we don't think about the ingredients. We just say, oh, I love this color.
Right.
You know, we don't understand that there's lead in that color, and lead causes cancer. And me being an ambassador for the Susan G. Komen Foundation, I have the opportunity to speak with many women, and some of the women have shared, you know, I never thought about my makeup. You know, I work out, I'm healthy, I've always eaten healthy, I don't smoke. How did I get cancer? And it's like, did you ever consider the lipstick? Because you're consuming it as you're eating, as you're drinking. You never think about that. And so I'm really big on the ingredients of the product. So I'm very passionate about my brand. You know, my customers say, you don't talk about it enough. You don't. I wish you would talk about it more. So I'm going to change that, you know, because because of my personality, I don't want people to feel like I'm pushing it on them.
Right.
You know, I will make recommendations, and I do every single day, but I just say, hey, here's my card, or check out the website. I don't say, hey, it's this, it's that, and oh, you got to have it. You know, now I have my moments, though. I do have my moments, especially when I see someone and she's orange, or I see a line, and I'm like, oh my God, her foundation is in match. I got to help her. So I have my moments where I'm like, I just go right in.
Right.
But in most cases, I just share a card with. You know, I'm extremely passionate about Nakia Cosmetics of Hollywood, and it's a brand that's very, very dear to my heart. I'm all in. When I say I'm all in, my hands are in every aspect, from the packaging. Someone posted in our Instagram stories today, a customer, and we reshared it, I noticed, because she said, this is excellence. She opened up the box. She saw the ribbon. She saw the packaging. And I said, that just blessed my heart, because I chose that ribbon. I chose that packaging. That's my ingredient in that container. And she said, oh my God, this is so beautiful. So every day I wake up and say, okay, for summer, we should do more purples and more, you know, more blue, red tones, you know. And I always think about every single friend, every single mother, every single actress. Oh, she will look good in this. Oh, she's blonde. She needs a blue red. Oh, she has dark skin. She needs more of an orangey red to make her deep undertones pop. So I'm very into this thing.
Yeah. No, I love
to the
it.
Point where my go away. And I'm like, no.
They're like, do we dare walk in? She's going to be like color matching us as soon as we come in. But no, this is good, because you're seeing this. Like, this is your gift. You can look at people and do that. That's how I feel about me with connecting people. I can match people up. Like, I could be a date matcher. Like, I meet people and I'm like, you two need
to. I'm single. Look, my friends are always trying to look me up. I'm like, no. But I'm going to put it out there.
Okay. If I find somebody, I'll connect you. Because I do this all the time. It's like, if you've got a gift, use it. And I think that's great, because you can see that. You have an eye for it and you can see it. And it's huge. I mean, image is huge. And that's why I said I always love looking at your photos, because they're very creative, and they're just, I don't know. You know, I don't know if you've got, I'm sure you got somebody helping you with that. They do a good job. The photos are really good. I like them.
Thank you.
So I think they're really good. So this is a fun question. I'm going to move into my rapid fire. I want to ask you this question. I didn't put it in the questions, but I know you'll be fine. So how would you define success? I want to hear this from you. How do you define success?
I would define success as happiness and peace.
I love that.
You know, a lot of people, when they think of success, they think of money. They think of, you know, monetarily. But for me, when you can wake up every day and just say, thank you, God, and you feel good and that peace just comes down. I literally take my time and I go to my coffee pot and I turn it on. I look out the window. That to me is success. I'm not like in a panic. I used to be. I remember waking up with anxiety every morning. Oh my God, where am I? What state am I in? What country am I in? What am I supposed to be doing? What did I miss? Now I wake up and I have such a peace, you know, and I said, okay, you know, and I go down my calendar, my to-do list. My mother says, you're maturing. You know, and I said, okay, I'll take that. But to me, this is what I call success when I'm not in a panic anymore. It's just, I just take my time. What's supposed to happen will happen. Let's make sure we stay on schedule. That's always the ultimate goal. Making sure that I'm focusing on accomplishing my goals for each one of my businesses and just being happy. You know, I think that is success.
That's happiness. Beautiful. I think that's beautiful. No, and you're right. A lot of people do define success as it's a financial thing. But I think when you get to that point, you're at that I think great place where you've created some things and now you're doing what you love. And to me, that's how I always talk about it. It's when you get to do what you love and you're at that peace, that's happiness. When you get to wake up and do the very thing that you're gifted at doing every day and you know you're making an impact, that's huge. You know what I mean?
Yes.
So 100% I'm with you. And that was such a beautiful way to put it. I love it, love it.
Thank you.
So when you're not doing cosmetics and all those fun things, because obviously you love all of that and you're very passionate about it. What else do you like to do for fun?
Oh my God. I love swimming. I'm a swimmer.
That's awesome.
Oh man. I love swimming. I love skating. I go skating on the beach. I love hanging out with my friends and just catching up on girl talk. You know, I try not to work when I'm with my girlfriends and they're like, I see you looking at me. My eyeliner isn't straight. So they're like, no work tonight. And I'm like, you know, and then I'm going, no, you look great. But I'm thinking if she could just wing it a little more.
Yeah. I wish you were here. I'd be like calling you every day. I'd be like, get over here and help me with my makeup. I've had enough experience of that, but that's not my gift. That's not necessarily my creative point. Like I said, I'm the connector, but I think that's awesome. And it is hard to not work when you enjoy what you do, it's a part of you, right? It just becomes who you are as an individual. But I love the skating. I'm sitting here visioning this right now, like skating on the beach. This sounds like incredible right now. So
yes, there's some images on my Instagram and on my blog of me on skates. And people told me, they said, you look so happy and like you're having such a good time. I grew up skating as a child with my brothers. And so skating and swimming or things, you know, there was a point where I wasn't physically active and I had health problems. And then I found my happiness. Let me say that.
Yeah.
I found my happiness. I began to lose weight. I began to eat better. I began to swim. I began I got a dog. I started walking my dog. So it's like a whole shift changed, even with my business. You know, that's when my business started making money. You know, I had to find my happiness. And that also came from, Jennifer, having the right people in your space.
100%.
You know?
Yeah.
You got to have good people around you, not people that are because of who you know, what you've done, what celebrities you've worked with, but people that truly like you, they truly care about you, they truly love being around you, and they care about your greatness. And once that shifted, which, you know, a lot of times our circles have to be very, very small when you reach a certain level in your career, you keep that circle very small and very intact of your biggest supporters.
Right.
And I make a point not to be selfish by showing them the same support that they give me. So there's like 3-4 of us. You know, we may meet up in Hawaii. We may meet up in Vegas. We may just meet down in Malibu and just go have a coffee, you know. And when I stop having an entourage of people, I'm trying to feed everybody. I'm trying to help everybody. I'm trying to, man, that wore me out. I mean, it wore me down.
Yeah.
I was beat up. I was just tired. My business was suffering. And once I got rid of all that baggage, it was like, hello, Nakia is here. The real Nakia without all the drama.
Yeah.
So I just want to share with someone who's listening out there that sometimes you may feel lonely. You may feel tired and exhausted. A lot of times that's the energies that are around you.
Mm.
And love yourself first. Be comfortable with loving yourself. I go for long walks on the beach. Even when I'm in Dallas, I go for long walks. I make a point to spend time alone to clear my head. So you got to be comfortable with being alone first and then keep that circle nice and tight so that you're not overwhelmed by other people's drama.
Yeah.
That way you can stay focused and you can keep a clear head and you can rest peacefully and focus on your vision. That's very important.
Yeah, this is all great stuff. You're beautiful. I love it. I love it.
Thank you.
So I got to ask you one more fun question here. If you could be any character besides Nakia, any character or superhero for a day, what would you pick?
Oh my gosh. Any character. Was going to say, two came to mind. It's so funny. Wonder Woman.
Okay.
Because of her superpowers.
Yes.
And we're doing a Wonder Woman campaign for Brunch and Beauties because we want to me, every woman is Wonder Woman.
Yes.
So we're going to do a whole thing on Wonder Women. Like, women can make stuff happen, man.
Yeah, I agree.
Oh man, and moms are superheroes all day long. I'm not a mother, but I look at all my mothers around the world. I'm like, how does she do it? She runs three businesses, she has four kids and a husband. Oh my God. You know, but Wonder Woman is definitely the character. And then I would say Diana Ross, because she's so glamorous.
Oh yeah.
I haven't had Diana with the hair and the voice, and she just gives you old Hollywood glam.
Yeah.
And I just, you know. Yeah, so I would say that if I could sing, oh, honey, I would get me some hair.
You just be on it.
I would put on a sequins gown, and I would just exude the glamour that Diana Ross gives. So
I love that.
I would definitely say Diana Ross.
Nobody said that. That one's good. I have not had anybody say that. I always like asking this question. There's a few of them that I ask in here. I always like to see what the responses are because I get some very unique answers sometimes. So that one's good. Nobody has said that. You got it. You got your own on that one. So, all right, Nakia. So, if our audience wanted to come find you, where do they look for you at?
They look for me at Nakia. Let me give it to you again. They look for me at www.nakiafuller.com, and that's NAKEAH Fuller, FULLER.com. That also links to my other website. You'll see NakiaCosmetics.com. Instagram, Nakia Cosmetics of Hollywood. And also Facebook, Nakia Fuller and Nakia Cosmetics of Hollywood. My blog is allthingsbeauty.blog. And so you can find me at any of those locations. I'm always on my laptop. I'm always chatting it up with people. Sometimes I'll pop in on the website when I see a customer chatting with my staff. I'll pop in and say, hey, girl.
That's you so
know,
fun.
No, get this red. Try this purple. You know, yeah. So I'm always trying to jump in there, but. Yeah, those are my websites. So NakiaFuller.com, NakiaCosmetics.com, AllThingsBeauty.blog, and Instagram at Nakia Cosmetics of Hollywood.
So I'm so excited now after talking to you because I looked at your site already. Now I want to get back in there. I got to go check your blog out. So I'm going to go back through there and start digging around in there. So excited. We'll be sure that when we kick this out, we'll get all your contact information in there so they know where to find you and check everything out. So this has been so much fun. I could keep you on here forever. I could have like 100 questions, but I know we all got things to do. And I'm so grateful that you took time to get on here and share with us all your greatness. I'm excited about your upcoming project. And we're definitely going to be looking to see if you put something out there on the TV. We're going to be looking for something. So you'll have to keep us posted on that one. And if I find a single partner for you, I'll let you know. So
All right.
I want to tell our listeners, if you enjoy our podcast, please be sure to give us a rating both on iTunes and Facebook, because of course we can't do this without you. And check out our YouTube, hit that subscribe button. And with that, I'm going to wrap up with our mantra. It's a great day to be brave. You might as well start now. You have the power to change your circumstances any day you decide. Let today be that day. Rise up, be amazing, be you, do you. All right, you guys take care, be safe, and be kind to one another. We'll see you next time.